We're asked, do the points on the graph below represent a function? Now, before even attempting to do this problem, let's just remind ourselves what they mean by a function. A function literally just takes some input, and it's usually kind of considered x, some number x, but it takes some input. Let me do it in a darker color. So it takes some input, let's call it x. And then it puts it into, it does something on it, or it maps it to another value. So you take your function takes x as an input, and then it outputs a unique value, or it says, I don't know what to do with x. If it outputs a unique value, that value is f of x. Or another way to think about it, maybe we could say that value is y, and you could say that y is equal to a function of x. You give me an x, and then the function does what it needs to do on the x, and then it outputs a y. Either way to visualize it. This function either has to say, let me give you a y and one unique y, or it'll say, I'm undefined. I don't know what to do with that x. A function cannot give you two different y's for the same x. That would just make it hard to specify what to map x to. So when they ask us, do the points on the graph below represent a function, we just really have to make sure that for every x value, there is only one y value that it is being mapped to, or for any x value that it's undefined. For example, at 6, they have not defined, and let me label the axes just to be careful. This is the x-axis, this is the y, or the y is equal to f of x axis. So if you tried to put 6 into this proposed function, it's undefined. They haven't told us what y would be equal here. That's completely cool. Over here, if you put negative 1 in this proposed function, it produces 3. That's cool. So far, this looks like it could represent a function. If it did, just based on this point, you would say that f of negative 1, because the input is negative 1, is equal to 3. Cool so far. Now, when x is equal to 2, so this, if our proposed function, when you input a 2, it'll output a negative 2. Seems reasonable so far. You input a 3, it'll output a 2. Still reasonable. Now, when x is equal to 4, if we want this to be a function, what this graph is implying is if you input x as equal to 4, that the value of the function, or the proposed function, is both negative 1 and 5. So this is kind of saying that if you take 4 into our function, into our proposed function, we can't really call it a function yet. We're trying to see if we can call it a function. So if you put into our proposed function, that it would be, that it could get to negative 1 and, or it could get to 5. And this is just not allowed. It is mapping the value 4 to two values. That is not allowed for a function. A function has to map from a value to only one other value. So the points on the graph below do not represent a function. So I'll just write a no here.